don't sweat the technique. Don't sweat the technique.
Welcome to Intro to Fibs. We're going to cover Fibonacci extensions and understanding how to use it. This is a very effective tool. It's overlooked by a lot of people. A lot of people don't think it works, and there's a lot of variations on how to use it and where you're supposed to use it is probably where most of that confusion comes in, but we're going to go over a basic way to use it day in and day out. It's been very effective for me in my trading. Gave me my first profitable year trading. So you can see on my chart here, we're going to go over these are the basic levels that you're going to see most often. 0, 23, 38%, 50%, 618, 78.6, 100, 127, 161. Now, there's been a lot of, discussion around these levels as far as 127, 161, a lot of people say 127.2, 123.6, whatever. There's a ton of different variations. This has been the most effective for me, the 127 and the 161. And so that's what we're going to cover today. But like I said, a lot of people, they use a lot of different levels. Now, most people draw their fibs, they use all of these levels. I don't. I have them up on the chart right now just so you can see and understand. And so I go into settings, I remove everything but these settings right here. I keep the 50%, change that color so you can see it a little bit better. Use the 50% and the 618 and 127 and 161. And so this is the trigger level that we're going to go over, and these are the target levels. And so what you're going to do is very simple. Any trend you see, so I would consider this a trend, and yes, I have Heiken Ashi on so that I can see trends better. This is a trend right here down. This is a trend right here up. So anytime you recognize a trend being broken, then you're just gonna measure it. And you can think of this as your measuring tape to see where we're headed in the market. And so from right here at the open, we have a long trend. So you're gonna take the swing high. Whoops. Swing high to swing low. Boom. And now what we're looking for is that when that trend is broken, so you can measure this as early as recognizing a couple candles and recognizing the trend is broken. I like to get this measurement early so that I know where price is going to retrace back to, so that I can wait for it and catch it down here. But this between this 50% and this 618 is the golden zone. This is where we're gonna take our trigger. This is where we want the retrace to land for support so that we can take this trade up. So there's a lot of factors going into whether this is gonna hold for support. You don't wanna just come down here and grab it the second it hits, but that's for another video. For now, this is the trigger zone. This is where we're gonna catch it. This is where we're gonna take the entry. We take that entry, our target is the 127. And once you've done this and use it over time, then you can start getting used to trading point A to point B, and all this noise that happens in the middle, you're not gonna worry about it because you're confident, you know when this hits, it's going to your target. So that's my way to do it. The reason why I like to do it that way is because it gives me a chance to see price retracing back and it being caught. The other version is going to be forward. And so if you look at this chart on the right, if we have a trend that's down and we don't have a move up yet, We're going to take the swing high down to the swing low. And what this does is lets us know if there's a reverse on or not. We need price to break through the golden zone. And when it does, that lets us know a reverse comes. And at that point, we have our target again. Boom, 127. Now there's a little bit different ways to take this trade. We'll go on another video, but what we're looking for in this situation overall is the reversal zone being cracked, so golden zone being cracked, and that triggers our target area, the 127. Now these can be done bearish as well. What I'm showing you is bullish. So let's assume this didn't reverse. You would take the swing low to the swing high. And the same thing as the first one, price would come up. If it couldn't reverse and it rejected, then we would have a downside target. The other cheat way to do this is go into your settings and add 0.0. Negative. And you can get a downside target, then you don't have to draw reverse fibs. You can just draw the same direction all the time. Now, I know I said I only use the 50% and the 618, but there's times where I'll notice that the market starts bringing things a little bit deeper, and I'll add the 38% on there, and that's another strong zone. And so these other levels are valuable in the sense that yes, they can still trigger the setup and trigger the target. This is just high probability area. You know, if we drop all the way down to the 23%, then it's not going to be that strong. The 38% can come in handy, but your strong trigger level, your high probability trades are going to come in this upper area, and that's what I like to keep on my charts, as well as I don't like to have my charts all clustered up. Now, the other thing with this is this can measure any time frame, any trend, any size, and it can also keep you in the market or keep you on a run and let you know something's still going. This isn't the greatest example, and I'm trying to bang this video out, so I don't want to hunt around for it. So all the way up the move, you're gonna see different size, 127, this one, 168, all the way up. So if something's running really hard, and this is to the downside as well, I'll just keep measuring every move. As soon as it gets to the target, boom, I measure it again. Boom, all the way up. If I don't end up staying in the trade the whole time, and I'll just keep taking trade after trade after trade, all the way up as we keep climbing. That's a basic way to use it. The other thing to add onto this is every morning, every single day for the past 6-7 years, the first thing I do when the bell rings is I wait for this. If I don't have a trade set up, which I only take one trade set up at the bell, but every single morning, the initial move that happens after the programs fire, overnight fills, and all the BS happens, boom, a trend will initiate, whether it's up or down. I'm watching and waiting for that trend to break. As soon as that opening trend breaks for the day and I measure it, that gives me an idea of our direction for the day. So if we hold this, boom, right here and hold this, okay, well, I'm gonna stay bullish for the day and I'm gonna be looking for trades. Even if I'm late to the party and didn't see this, I would still set this up and have an idea of the direction that we're going. If we break this right away in the morning, then I'm gonna be looking downside and things are gonna change. And me personally, I'm going to draw the fib the other way. I'm going to draw from the downside like this. So that's a great way to start your day off. It's a great first trade. It's an effective first trade. If you only took this trade every single day, this first opening trade, and you waited and looked and planned for something to set up perfectly every day on this, then you would hit higher than 90% of your trades. It's not gonna, might not give you a trade every single day, especially in the conditions we've been facing right now, because it's real nasty. But when the market's trending, you'll get a trade every day. But either way, if you wait for it to set up properly, you're gonna get a high probability trade every single time. All right, that's it for the basics on the Fibs. Tune into the next videos and we'll go take a little bit deeper dive into it.